Hey, I'm Sean, co-founder and president at the Rusty Shovel Landscape Shop, and if you're watching this video, chances are you've got a landscape design consult booked with us, or you're at least thinking about it. So I really wanted to just say thank you for doing that. We're really looking forward to working with you and bringing your yard to life. And just wanted to give you a little insight into how our process works and what you're in for over the next little bit. So where we start is with a two-hour on-site design consultation. So what's going to happen, we're going to come out to the yard. Hopefully you've had a chance to fill out the questionnaire in advance to kind of give us a little bit of a head start. But what we're going to do is spend a little bit of time getting to know you, what you want to do with your yard as far as what you want it to look like and what you want to use it for, so that we can functionally create a space that's going to work for you. The other thing that we're going to need to do is we're going to need to get an idea of what kind of budget we're working with. So that's not for us to just figure out how much money we can squeeze out of you. What it is for us to be able to get an idea of what we're trying to build within your budget. So we can design beautiful functional yards for $10,000. We can design beautiful functional yards for $100,000. But the two don't look the same. And so what we don't want to do is make assumptions on how much we think that you should want to spend. We want to work with you to establish that budget. So we've got some other videos on how to figure that out as well, if you're interested. So from there, we're going to go off and take some measurements of your space. So get an idea for all that, and get some sketches, get a sketch done. So come up within that 2 hours, you're going to get a concept sketch of what that yard could look like. So from there, what we're going to do is give you a price on what it's going to cost to get a more detailed computerized design completed. So this is completely optional. Some people will take the pencil sketch, the concept, and run with that. A lot of our do-it-yourselfers do that. But I highly recommend at least looking at the computerized options. So typically what we're looking at is between an extra $400 to $1,000 is generally what you're looking at for something like that, depending on what the complexity is. We will quote you a firm price on what it is to do that. And so here's why I recommend doing that. We're going to get a detailed 2D plan of a few different things. So all your plants are going to be located on and spec'd out, every single species, every single plant. You're going to get a hardscape plan, so you know where everything goes, how much of everything, material takeoffs done for you in detail to the inch. So that's all done for you. A lighting plan as well, so you know where the lights are going to go, and then a working plan for us to do things like irrigation quotes and contractor notes and that sort of thing. So that's the blueprint side of it. The next part is the 3D photoreal renderings. So you're going to get pictures of your landscape, what it's going to look like with the trees in full maturity. If you have any walls or any structures or anything like that, it's going to give you a full look, because even me being in the business, I look at a 2D plan and I don't fully grasp what that space is going to look like. Jesse, our landscape designer, he knows what it's going to look like, but you want to know what you're getting at the end of the day before you actually invest that much money and build it. So really, really good. And then the last thing that we've added to those 3Ds is actually a really cool virtual reality experience. So we've got a HTC Vive headset set up here at the shop, where you can actually go through, it takes you, if you've never been through VR before, it virtually teleports you into the space. So what it does is spatially you can feel what that space is going to be like before it actually gets built. So if you're standing on a pathway, the first one that Jesse showed me, I'm standing on a pathway and I'm like, that doesn't feel very wide. Why does that path feel very narrow? Well, because it's 3 feet wide. Oh, okay. We tell people that a 3 foot path is too narrow, but actually standing on it, I could feel that, okay, maybe 4 feet is a little bit better, or 5 feet is a little bit better. And now it all comes back to that budget thing, but at least we can make a decision that, okay, no, 3 feet, the pathway is not where we want to save some money. We want to save it somewhere else. So those are the things that really help going through that process. So regardless of what you do, after that process is finished, what we're going to do is have you in here for what we call a shop consult. So with that shop consult, you're coming to meet with our materials specialist. Now that we've established the scope of your project, of what you're going to do, now we need to figure out what you're going to build it out of. So we're going to take you through and show you what your options are for different things like paving stone or artificial turf or ground cover with your rocks and your mulches and that sort of thing, with different edging options, your walls, your paving stone, all of that stuff. There's tons of choices from price point to style to color. All that stuff needs to be gone through. So we'll take you through, make sure that you're comfortable with all the choices. After we've established the scope of the project, what you're going to do, the products, what you're going to build it out of, we're going to do one of two things. Either, if you're going to do it yourself, we're going to get your materials quote on everything that you're going to need to build the project and ways that you can stage it to get it done, give you all the instructions that you're going to need to be able to get your project finished successfully. The other thing that we can do is, if you don't want to do the work yourself, that's perfectly fine. So we don't self-perform any of our own work. We don't have our own in-house crews, but that's because we work with dozens of landscape companies that do that for a living, and we work on a referral basis. So instead of just handing you a bunch of cards and say, here, call these guys, try and get a hold of them, somebody might return your call, we make those calls on your behalf, get you some quotes. The quote goes directly to you. You make the decision on who you want to hire, but we're working to create a relationship where everybody knows each other. So we've got the designer, the supplier, the contractor, and the homeowner all kind of working together in a seamless process, as opposed to being disjointed with a bunch of ideas we create. We try and implement the design together as a partnership. So we try and make that as seamless as possible. We make the calls on your behalf, get that out there, relay the information for you so that you don't have to try and remember, well, what was that stone that we picked, and what was the thing that we wanted here, and we make sure that all the necessary details are relayed to the contractor. So that's a little bit of glimpse. Hopefully that paints the picture a little bit better on how we're going to get you from a blank piece of dirt or a complete rip out or a little bit of a redo to an actual finished project, whether you want to do the work yourself or whether you want to hire it done. So trying to, we've worked with hundreds of customers on this process. We're always refining it, trying to improve it all the time, so that you can have a really easy process of getting this done and you get the yard that you always wanted.